Code is what software is made from, and software has such a strong effect on every aspect of our lives. In the way that our data is collected and analyzed by the government, by social media, decisions and policies are made based on algorithms that get parsed. The result of those algorithms is, you know, how we live. This paper written by Claude Shannon in 1948, The Mathematical Theory of Communication. That's really the basis for modern digital communication. The way information's transferred through the internet protocols is you have a piece of information, an email, a photograph, and it's broken down into these packets. And those packets go on different routes, and then they're reassembled and checked before they become that final piece of media. My version of a mathematical theory of communication, which really isn't about mathematics at all, it's more a visual theory of communication. I took multiple streams, took pieces of them, broke them into these small square pieces, and then put those all within the same visual space. And that became the source material for this piece. And so it's multiple channels, pieces of those channels, in this two-dimensional array. On the day I visited campus, I met with many of the computer science faculty, and I also met with the students as well. There's a lot of work being done here in computer vision, this idea of how do we teach machines to see. And it's stereo, like you have these two images and you're comparing and contrasting them with each other, and that's what creates depth. And this installation uses these two views of the same source data, and we have these two walls that are largely similar, but they're mirrored. In each of the two walls, we're looking at the same material, the same data, but from different points of view, from different perspectives. In the end, I selected two that had converging energy, and so the idea is that they're converging towards the atrium in the center of the space. So each one, in a way, moves out of the corner that's opposite the other piece. I think of code like a tool. We use a chisel to kind of amplify our hands. We use a brush to also amplify our arms. And computers and code and software is a way of more amplifying the mind. It allows me to think in a different way, which allows the work to progress in a different way. That's where the craft and technique of programming and code come in. The piece for Landmarks is actually television media, the shows that are being watched by the most people, in the millions of people who are being influenced by these. And it's actually all one-hour crime dramas and the advertisements that play simultaneous to that. We have the original communication, the original media. We have the transmission and then the reception. And so basically in that middle step, I'm pulling out the data. So in a way, the data of that transmission really becomes the substance that I'm building my work out of. When I experience that piece and at its full scale, I need there to be some sort of immediate structure for you to be able to lock into it. But I want there to be a situation where the longer you look, the more you see these micro compositions within the piece. Your eyes are never able to fix on any one point, but you're able to pause in different places and find order and structure, and then you move to somewhere else and you land on another sort of micro composition within the larger piece. That's very much the intention of the work. That's how I experience the piece, and it's how I hope other people will experience it too. In my case, I don't make changes to that thing that's on the wall, I make changes to the code. Then the code produces a new artifact that then I can look at and think about. I think it's gone to the full end, where it's become pure and total abstraction. I removed about 9 lines. I think there's a few million lines in the piece, and I think I hand-edited out about 9 that were bothering me in the piece.